My name is David Adams. I'm the director of the Centre for Liver Research and the NIHR Biomedical Research Unit in Liver Disease at the University of Birmingham. The prevalence of liver disease is increasing, and non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, which is a complication of the metabolic syndrome, is now the commonest reason for referral to liver clinics in the developed world. Transplantation is frequently the only successful treatment for patients with end-stage liver disease, so there is a pressing need to develop new therapies. We have previously described a role for a protein called vascular adhesion protein 1, or VAP1, in the recruitment of leukocytes to the liver in inflammatory liver disease. This protein is unusual because, as well as being an endothelial adhesion molecule, it's also an enzyme. It has amine oxidase activity and catabolizes primary amines to the corresponding aldehyde, ammonia, and hydrogen peroxide. Given that we have reported a role for vascular adhesion protein 1 in liver inflammation and previously shown that it's released as a soluble protein from the liver in inflammatory liver disease, we measured the levels of this protein in the blood of patients with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease and compared the levels to a group of matched metabolic controls without liver disease. In the present study, we show that non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is associated with significantly elevated levels of circulating vascular adhesion protein 1, and that the concentration of the protein in patient serum was associated with an increased risk of mortality and correlated with the extent of hepatic fibrosis.
We investigated hepatic expression of VAP1 across the spectrum of NAFLD using immunohistochemistry and found that the staining was more pronounced in diseased livers when compared to normal liver controls. In addition to our NAFLD data, we have also demonstrated that this was true of other chronic end-stage liver diseases. Multicolour confocal microscopy confirmed that the expression of VAP1 co-localised with markers of hepatic stromal cells. VAP1 has previously been associated with leukocyte recruitment across hepatic sinusoidal endothelium, but little is known of the role of stromal VAP1. We have demonstrated that primary human hepatic stromal cells express enzymatically active VAP1, the expression of which is modulated by pro-fibrotic cytokines. Stromal cells also express a secreted form of the protein, which induced a hydrogen peroxide-dependent leukocyte migration in vitro.
To investigate the role of VAP1 in a fibrotic setting in vivo, we employed a carbon tetrachloride model of murine hepatic fibrosis. Wild-type mice, VAP1 knockout animals, and wild-type mice dosed with an anti-VAP1 blocking antibody were injected twice weekly with carbon tetrachloride. We discovered that both VAP1 knockout mice and those receiving the blocking antibody had reduced fibrosis, and that this was associated with a reduction of intrahepatic inflammatory cell populations. To further elucidate the role of VAP1 in the development of hepatic fibrosis, we also used three murine models of fatty liver disease, namely a high-fat diet, methionine-choline deficient diet, and Western lifestyle diet. In all three models, we consistently saw a reduction in hepatic steatosis, inflammation and fibrosis following antibody blockade or disruption of the VAP1 gene. In a parallel study, mice that expressed a catalytically inactive form of VAP1 were fed methionine choline deficient diet. These mice exhibited reduced hepatic inflammation and fibrosis, consistent with the idea that the amine oxidase activity of VAP1 contributes towards the development of chronic liver disease.
To confirm that the effects of VAP1 on chronic liver disease is not just a consequence of the increased inflammatory cell recruitment, we investigated the direct effects of VAP1 on stromal cell function in vitro. Using a real-time cell imaging platform, we monitored wound closure of an hepatic stellate cell line. We demonstrated that overexpression of VAP1 accelerated wound closure, whereas siRNA knockdown of VAP1 retarded the healing response. Real-time PCR experiments revealed that the expression of enzymatically active FAP1 was associated with that of other fibrotic mediators, such as collagen 1 and lysyl oxidase like 2.
Our study suggests that FAP1 plays a complex role in the progression of liver disease, from driving the inflammatory response to liver injury to promoting the fibrosis which recurs subsequent to that inflammation. Therefore, targeting FAP1 therapeutically, either with blocking antibodies or with enzyme inhibitors, could prove to be a novel way of preventing the progression of liver disease.